Welcome back to Rutiger and to the final of the mixed team sprint. Good to have you with us as we continue the 29th Winter Universiade from Krasnoyarsk in central Siberia. And the stands pretty full for this one. The locals especially hoping that the Russian Federation might bring them another victory. Very good chance. They've got both their teams in the final. Finland and Italy also have two teams in the final, which comprises 10 teams altogether. And the 10 fastest qualifiers out of the two semi-finals have made it through, rather than five from each, which we were initially led to believe would be the case. It was actually the 10 fastest qualifiers, and in fact, only three teams made it through from the second semi. Here's the work being done again in the wax room. Multiple pairs of skis prepared, and the work seemingly never stops in this place. Strong arms and a good back. And an understanding of the weird science of waxing skis is necessary.
The Canadians are silly.
And it's minus two, but with a breeze. Feels a little cooler than that, I can tell you, outside. The wind direction from the southwest, around 3 metres per second. It's an overcast day, but still no sign of snow. I don't think we're going to get any to change the conditions as they appear to you now. And the number one Russian team were indeed the quickest qualifiers in 22:40. Czech Republic, Russia 2, Finland, Italy, Kazakhstan 1, Italy, Switzerland, Japan and Finland. So there are your 10 qualifiers, and it would seem that Terentyev and Matsukina, maybe they've got it between them, but the Czech Republic won't be far behind. Sobakarev and Nekrasheva, their time was about 35 seconds slower than the number one Russian team. Tsierny and Hintsetsova must be a chance, but Cerny's going to have to ski three laps, the like of which he's not skied before, I think. Away we go. And for the Russian Federation in Team 1, it's Alexander Terentyev, and their second team is led off by Andrei Sobakarev. So they are in the two red strips. And the Italian teams are in kind of olive green. We'll talk you through the field as they make their way around what will be six laps in all, three for the men, three for the women. And there were no real dramas in the exchange area through the semi-finals, which was great to see. The Russian Federation keen to lead it and to dominate, and perhaps ski is a mini team of their own, the two of them going out now, Terentyev and Sobakarev. Off to the left there, 8 and 13, the two teams from Switzerland and Finland. Kazakhstan led off by Ivan Luft. So the Russian Federation just still settling into first and second there. 10 there is Yusso Markela. 13, beg your pardon, is Finland. We've got start positions and bib numbers, and I was crossing them over in my mind there for a moment. And team 8 is Finland, and 13, 8 and 13. Kazakhstan is team number 10. They're just settling in there. Ivan Luft behind the Russians. There's Terentyev. Just opens up a little bit of a lead here, and Kazakhstan chasing them down the descent into the arena. Russia 1 and 3, and look at the difference in the running speed of the skis. And this has been a feature of the racing today. In both semi-finals, the Russian skis seem to have a deeper and finer understanding of the snow conditions, and they've got their skis waxed very well. So Russia 1 and 2 will be first to hand over. Italy 2 there will be represented by Martina Bellini. And team number 23, she's just on the left of screen there. And team 11 also is Italy. That'll be Francesca Franchi. And the first exchange finds Russia 2 just ahead of Russia 1 by half a second. The top seven all in it, but Finland and the Czech Republic, Finland 2 and Czech Republic off the pace a bit, so a slow first lap skied by Czerny. And he's left his teammate Petra Intsintseva with a lot to do. And Nakrasheva on the right there, team 10. Is Kazakhstan, Elmira Mutagarova. As Francesca Franchi continues to lead on this second lap of the team sprint final. Just sits ahead of Matsukina. And Nakrasheva. Kazakhstan there also with Mutagarova. And Katri Lilinpera has made a big move for Finland on the left of your screen there. After the first lap skied by Yuna Sarkkinen, she's made up a lot of ground. And she's moved to the front. Franchi now back to fourth with the two Russians in between. And Katri Lilinpera has swept to the front to give Finland a real chance here. This is the Finland number one team, their second team towards the rear of the field, but Finland coming through. And just half a second lead over the first Russian team, then Russia 2, Italy 1, then the Czech Republic. So a good second leg skied as expected by Petra Intsintseva. She's going to have to play catch up after each exchange, it would seem. Just for the moment, holding off Torrentev and Sobakarev. Torrentev in second, Sobakarev third at the moment for the two Russian teams. Two Italians skiing quite close together in the green outfits. And Kazakhstan through Ivan Luft, trying to force his way through the field again. And he'd be sitting in fifth position at the moment. Down into the stadium once more. They ski on the diagonal towards the big screen, straighten up towards the far end of the stadium, and then make a left-hand turn in front of the main grandstand. And suddenly, the Russians have made their move. Torrentev and Sobarakev have moved past Finland's Sarkkinen. Crowd likes the look of that. Russia 1-2. Then Finland and Italy. Here's the changeover area. So Russia 1 and 2, then Finland, then Italy 1 and 2, then Kazakhstan, Japan and Finland, number 2, followed by Switzerland and the Czech Republic. Well, there's a very interesting trend in this race with the Czech Republic. It's obvious that Ondrej Czerny, the male half of the team, is struggling to keep pace. And he's asking too much, I think, of Petra Intsintseva to push the Czechs into contention. She'll do her best, but she's a long way back now. They made the changeover 12 and a half seconds down on Russia.
Well,
Fourth lap. Very interesting now to watch whether Kati Limpera has another fast circuit in her. Russia looking for their sixth gold medal today. And they're in prime position to get that done. They're holding down first and second here, and Limpera for Finland. And then Franchi for Italy. There's just 1.5 kilometres out on course. And the Russian boys have got time for a chat and a little discussion of tactics for what will be the second last lap for them. And making a bit of an effort now is Sarkkinen. Really, he hasn't got room, I don't think, to step across to the inside. Yes, he does. He charges over. So Limpera. It is the Sarkkinen waiting. Limpera steps across in front of the other two. And Sarkkinen just gives her a wave and says, here I am, come through and find me. And she charges through the two Russians. That's pretty bold. And out they go once more. So Sarkkinen for Finland. And the lead is nothing, really, less than a second over the two Russian teams. So it's Sarkkinen from Sabakarev and Terentev and then Mozzolini of Italy. Finland, Russia, Russia, Italy. So this is the penultimate lap. A little bit of a move there coming from Terentev on the inside of Sarkkinen. And Terentev takes the lead. Going to test the legs of Sarkkinen, see if he can go with the two Russian boys. Terentev leading now from Sabakarev. Then Sarkkinen, then Mozzolini. Oh, Russia saying, let's go. And Sarkkinen is struggling to go with them. So too, Mozzolini. Is this the defining moment of the final? Well, suddenly that lead is substantial. Sarkkinen's got to find something in his wearying legs, but look at this pace being established by Terentev and Sabakarev. And the waiting skiers in the arena can see what's happening. Although now as the picture shifts to what's happening in that ski area, the preparation area, they don't know, but they do know now that it is Sabakarev and Terentev. Terentev just having a little bit of trouble with traction, I think, there. And he has to settle in behind Sabakarev for the moment. We know their skis are running well on the downhill sections. Maybe just not quite so sound on the grip in the middle of the ski in this classic style. But they are working really hard. They have not let up in this fifth lap. And that's quite a lead that they now have over Sarkkinen. And the crowd is delighted to see them come into the stadium in this position. Russia side by side. Terentev and Sabakarev. Terentev to hand over to Ristina Matsukina. Sabakarev's partner is Polina Nakrasheva. And in they come. And they've got a lead of close to 100 metres now over Finland. So Russia, one and two. And it's actually Matsukina who will lead it out for Russia ahead of Nakrasheva. And on form, I think Matsukina should be able to hold off her teammate. And it's a long way back to Limpera, who's skied very well for Finland, but that gap is surely too big even for Katri to close. The gap was 12 seconds between the Russians and Finland. Another 4 seconds back to Italy. So still a good chance for a fight for the bronze medal between Finland 1 and Italy 1. And Francesca Franchi, very good skier for Italy. And she'll be chasing Lilinpera. It is Matsokina who's established a 5-meter lead now over a teammate Nekrasheva. And it's looking like it'll be Terentyev and Matsokina because Oristina Matsokina is stretching this lead of Nekrasheva. Nekrasheva can't go with her. And then it's a long way back to Katri Lilinpera and Francesca Franchi of Finland and Italy, respectively. So I think we've got our place getters pretty much settled. Russia, 1, 2. Finland or Italy, 3rd. Just looks to have an easier rhythm about her method, does Ristina Matsokina. Leading and continuing to increase the margin of Nekrasheva, who's a very good sprinter, but this third lap in quick time might just starting to sort out her endurance, I think. Matsokina seems to have plenty left. And Nekrasheva should have enough of a margin to hold off Lilinpera, but she is closing, and Franchi has Lilinpera in her sights. That'll be the battle for third between these two, Finland and Italy. It's only 4 seconds in it. Not a lot of time, though, for Franchi to close that gap with Lilinpera. But we're into the stadium now with Ristina Matsokina, and the crowd is delighted to see her in front. And they'll be pleased also to see Nekrasheva come in second place. So the two Russian teams filling the top two spaces. Only allowed two teams to enter the competition. They've got them both through to the final, and they're going to be on the podium in the expected order. Even if the second Russian team wasn't the second fastest qualifier, they've got plenty left for the final as Nekrasheva makes this last turn into the home straight. But she will trail in Ristina Matsokina, who's only got 50 metres to ski now. She looks over the shoulder to see how far back Nekrasheva is. She can stand up now and ease into the line. And Terentyev comes out to congratulate her. Oh, wonderful moment for those two. Also for Sobakarev as he will greet Nekrasheva. Second. And Finland, will we get third? Yes, they do. And they are delighted with that. Sarkkinen and Lilinpera. Russia 1-2, Finland 3rd, Italy 4th. All done in 18 minutes, 7 seconds, 0.52 for Russia 1.
No.
Oh, thanks.
Mozzolini and Franchi. Good race into fourth position for the Italians. 22:11, let me correct the time. 22:11:37 and 22:22, so 10 seconds the margin between Russia 1 and 2 as our screens are updated for the final margins. 22:11 for Russia 1. Russia 1, Terentyev and Matsokina. From Russia 2, Sobakarev and Nekrasheva. and Finland 1, Sarkkinen and Lilinperä. They are your place getters, or major place getters, in the mixed team sprint final. Time now for the medals for the mixed team sprint final. Much anticipated moment for the teams from Russia and from Finland. Finland completing the journey in 22 minutes and 29 seconds. About 17 seconds behind the winning Russian combination and 7 behind the second place getters, Russia 2. Andrei Sobakarev and Polina Nekrasova. 22 minutes and 22 seconds was their time. 55 seconds quicker than their semi-final winning time. They just needed some quicker company around them to come up with a quicker time, and they certainly had that in the final.
Kristina Matsokina.
Terentyev and Matsokina, both medalists in the sprint. Terentyev, the gold medalist in the men's event, and Matsokina, silver in the women's. So there was every reason to expect they'd do well today. They won their semi-final in the quickest time, and they were too good in the final. The number one team from Russia taking out the mixed team sprint. Russia just adds to their medal tally. So coming up to today, they had 5 gold, 5 silver and 6 bronze. So that's 6 gold and 6 silver now. And Finland join the list of nations to pick up a medal at the cross country with their bronze in the mixed team sprint. Good racing, good conditions, a little grey and cool, but another fine event at Rautaga.